Sometimes I think I woke up in a pile of smoldering debris. And I met someone, a stranger. And over time, well, that stranger isn't a stranger anymore at all. I don't believe in luck or fate or any of that. But I do know that I wouldn't have changed.
Oh.
I never imagined that I would share a home with somebody wonderful.
Call it the Great War now. It's not been long, and things have been rough. Welcome to Survivor Stories. I'm Dasa Ben-Ami, a responder. I've been working with the responders for a couple years now. I'm from Charleston originally, so it was easy to join up. But it was work. Rebuilding Appalachia from the rubble while survivors flocked to us regularly from all over. Their stories untold, their names lost to time. I thought we should preserve this history somehow. I've decided to ask people to record their thoughts, their stories, anything they want to preserve forever. I'll call this series the Survivor Stories. I'll start with me. I was named by college final year. I was printing my thesis when I heard the sirens. I thought for sure my father, a Vault-Tec employee, could take us all with him, but only I refused to go. With my little brother, he went into the vault. They could not persuade me, though they tried. In the end, I pushed them inside it, and that was it. After that, I went back home to Charleston, and well, survived. Eventually, the responders formed, and I signed up right away. It was so hard. The flood, devastating. Relocating to Morgantown Airport and now Flatwoods has been... I remain optimistic. Been with them now for, I guess 2 years. We have big plans. We can do so much to help. Maybe, just maybe, we can rebuild enough to be okay. And in the meantime, I will continue to record stories of survivors when I can. We are your history. This is Dasa Ben on me, signing off for now. Well, my back hurts. Ziggy varmints with two pair of eyes. Yeah, I tell them I see the big old boomer out yonder. They tell me, what's a boomer then? Then some sweet young thing come up to me asking for help with that garden next door. And then just this morning, I hear talk of crawdads big as a barn door across the mountains and worse. Flatwoods had better days. Now everything cattywampus or it'll kill you. Now, I ain't no cussing lady. But damn if God had just let a bomb fall on my head. Jesus, just let me die.
vault suits like yours sure are popular lately.
This weather makes everything damp. It's too wet to be outside. So what's your story, Dweller?
Oh, hey! My savior! What can I do for you? Well, firstly, name's Luca. I help out around here. Going with some of the caravans and the like. Vinny's my uncle. Been staying with him a little while. Go on some of the routes sometimes. Stretch my legs and all that. Been trying to contribute to Blue Ridge. I don't do much, but I can make a half-decent explosive. It's got its perks. No one wants to start shit with the boss's nephew, you know? But Uncle Vinny is not the coddling type either. I don't get a free pass. Started as a hobby. Kept trying chemistry, and I was pretty awful at making things that didn't blow up. He's worried about them not being up to par. But they're good quality. Uncle Vinny just doesn't want any, mishaps. Accidental detonations and such. Says it looked bad on the business. They're as safe as any other explosives. Mostly. Once it's foolproof, I'll convince him.
It's too wet to be outside.
Sure they would! It's a multi-purpose item. All sorts of things you can do with explosives. Seal off that mole rat nest for good, defend your home, parties, home renovations, landscaping. Only limit is what you can think of. What do you want to know? Sure thing.
Don't be shy. Come, talk. Well, I was born and raised not far from here. I ended up leaving not long after becoming a ghoul. Let's say things got a little dangerous. Nowadays, I live in a small compound out in the hills. Just ghouls there, doing what we can to survive. You mean the folks keeping me alive? What did you want to know? Huh. Well, when he's not brooding, he's moody. But Kieran has a good heart. I know that for a fact. He's about as fun as Swampage, though. Don't tell the others, but Libby is my guard of choice. Things just run a lot more smoothly with her at the helm. Her family basically raised her like it was boot camp. I know they drive her batty, but they sure brought her up right. She's a real professional. Be sure to come back now.
Great. Now it's gonna be pouring down rain.
Thank you. Step right up. Everyone says the same thing. Guard the Brahmin. Sure, that's important. But me, I'd aim for those caches. Vinny pays a mean bonus for those things. Between you and me, I think he sells it himself. I sure as hell haven't gotten any missing pepperoni rolls sent back my way. If you know what I mean. My family runs a cannery and a bakery a few days from here. Like Mama Dolce's up near Morgantown. Less killer communist robots, though. Anyways, my brothers run the place. And for a while, I was the resident comedian. You know, telling jokes to guys working the machines. I called myself Director of Morale Enhancement. But my brothers wanted me to take my act on the road. Now, I get to risk my neck running deliveries, telling jokes, and selling pepperoni rolls to you fine people. See you later, then.
I'm sore all over. Building this place up is hard work.
One more box of raw asbestos, I'm gonna lose my mind. One person's junk is another's gold book. £5 of aluminum, £10 of steel. Possibly. What's the going rate on Wonder Glue in Appalachia?
Okay, everyone. Today, we're going to be recovering ore to decon. I need some of you in those tunnels gathering goods. Some up here, guarding the stash of my people. Don't expect a reward if my people go down. Their survival is a priority. And don't forget it. Ghouls don't like us messing around down there, so gather as much as possible before they overwhelm us. Let's go.
Thank you. This place has a lot of potential.
Sunny makes a good hoagie. I know a guy who could fix that. Sunny makes a good hoagie.
Attention, this here's Raleigh Clay on a priority message recording. A strangler heart's been picked up in the vicinity and its vine-infested creatures won't be far behind. To anyone listening, take down that heart before it controls too many creatures and things get out of hand.
Sorry, no time to chat.
Heck, sure is damp out here. Clean up this, fix that. Ugh, it never seems to end.
Processing machines at Mama Dolce's have finally cooled down enough to work again. I've set them up to make cans of stew using the ingredient containers spread around the factory. Well, machines make a hell of a racket, so you'll probably get some unwanted guests.
Thank you.
gate.
Clothes. I'm getting really muddy.
Morning. People have come back to this area. They'll all want to be setting up places like Foundation.
emblem squatters have been removed. Check in with me from time to time. I may have additional assignments for you to carry out.
You need some? Or just admiring? This is Big Ben Tunnel, under the management of the Blue Ridge Caravan Company. If you want the whole sales pitch, talk to the boss, Joanna, down at the west end of the tunnel. If you're looking to make a quick cap, talk to me. Looking for work, are you? Well, sure. Just so happens I've got something I'm willing to pay for. The bums around here haven't been pulling their weight as much as I'd like. But I also don't have the time or temperament to play therapist. You go give them a talking to? Then I'll send some gaps your way. Start with Kieran Kennedy. He's down on the west end of the tunnel. He knows better. So, remind him. He's one of my old crew from ways back. He's not known for clowning around. So if something's eating him, we should fix it. Okay, great, whatever. Get him back in shape, you get some caps. Now beat it.
Something I can help you with? Yeah, he always says that. But, yeah, fine. I guess I've been distracted. I've got these kids I watch back home, outside Appalachia. The only reason I do this work is to send caps back to them. But I'm starting to worry that they need more than protection and money. They've had their whole chance of childhood robbed from them. I had my eye on this place called Nuka World, just down the road. Some traveling carnival. The type of thing they'd love to see. The journey here, though, too dangerous for them. Wouldn't risk it. The road is no place for kids like them. But I've been thinking, maybe I could bring back a few toys or souvenirs from there. Think you'd be able to do that for me? It'd really help out. I appreciate that. 5 should be enough. Thanks.
Great. You're back.
Find any souvenirs? Ah, I see. I've been reconsidering. Thank you. I appreciate you getting them, but I'm starting to think that the souvenirs will only make them sadder. To see something from a place, a time, that they can't go to. Guess you're right. Even growing up before the war, I didn't have many chances to be a kid. Anything is better than nothing.
In this weather.
You can tell that old crank that I'll pick up the pace. Be seeing you.
Back. Hopefully with news of Mr. Kennedy lifting a Brahmin in each hand, carrying him from foundation to the pit. Caring with them damn kids. I warned him he wasn't cut out for playing house. Glad you figured it out for him. Good job. Come back tomorrow. I'll have something else for you to handle.
Looks like it might rain later.
Hey, good to see you again.
get over how much better I feel.
The headaches are still there, but barely.
You doggone degenerate! added his plunder to your door.
Glad you're here.
Get over how much it
The headaches are still there.